In this video, we will demonstrate how we can control a delta P across two separate pressurized pipelines while using the process gas as the inlet for the reference pressure controllers. But first, let's go through the setup. At the start, we have a gas bottle that is filled with air and pressurized up to 100 bar. Then we have these two regulators. This one controls the pressure we set on top of the diaphragms for the flow controllers. Here and here. And this one controls the pressure inside of the system. Then we have two flow controllers to simulate a flow in the system. Downstream of the flow controllers, we have two delta P sensors, one Keller and one Vega. Then we have one regular pressure sensor that we use to control the pressure inside this pipe. And at the back, we have two equilibar bed pressure regulators. On top of these equilibars, we have two ERCs. This one is a leader and this one is a follower, because this controls his pressure based on his signal. So this signal is fed into this PID controller, and this PID controller controls this valve. The other one, which is the follower, controls this valve based on the signal of this delta P sensor. This Vega delta P sensor is used for visualization since it has a nice screen. So right now we are running with two flows through the system, one of 1.5 kilograms an hour, this one of 1 kilogram an hour. Currently we have a delta P of -6 and a pressure of 0. That means that right now we have atmospheric conditions under which we have a stable delta P. I can increase the pressure inside of the system by giving a set point to this ERC, and I can do that through the software. Let's go to 2% and also give a set point of 50% to the delta P controller. So the green line you can see here is the process pressure that is measured by this sensor. The red line is the set point for that process pressure controller. The yellow line is the delta P that is measured by this sensor. And the blue line is its set point for the delta P controller. So right now we are at stable process pressure of 1.2 bar. And our delta P is controlling, and we're nearly at stable condition. While we wait, I will just show you the setup. So currently we have a stable delta P of roughly 10 millibars. This means that we have a pressure here of 1.2 bars, and in this one with a delta P of 10 millibar, we will have a pressure of 1.19. I can change the process pressure to, for example, 10 bar. We can see a drop in delta P, and it is trying to control the full scale of the entire delta P from 100% to 0%. Is total is 1 bar, so -500 and +500 millibar. And while the process pressure is increasing, we can see that the delta P is already becoming stable again. We have reached a stable process pressure, and our delta P is also almost stable. these are the flows we are running at. We can see the numbers more closely. Now we have stable delta T. I showed on the VDA as well. It's roughly 1 millibar. I then change the set point for the flows as well. Let's go twice as much on both flow controllers. This one will go to 1 kg/h. This one will go to 2. We can see that there is no change in process pressure, but there is a slight change in delta P. As soon as the flows have reached their set point, we will see that the delta P will become stable once again. Our flow has reached the set point, and we can see that our delta T is becoming stable again. Up to almost 0 millibar.